welcome to the geography class. The lesson that I am going to take today is lesson number 12, Agriculture in India, part 3, Cash Crops, with the following objectives. Through this lesson, we will learn about the cash crops like cotton, jute, oilseeds, sugarcane, tea and coffee under the following headings: importance or characteristics of each crop, their types or varieties, their geographical requirements, that is, type of soil, temperature and rainfall required, their methods of cultivation, problems of each crop, area, states where these crops are grown in India, along with the largest producer of each crop. In the previous videos related to lesson number 12, Agriculture in India, part 3, Cash Crops, we have studied cotton, jute, oilseeds, that is edible and non-edible oilseeds, with the following objectives: to know what type of crops are cotton, jute, groundnuts, mustard, soybean, linseed and castor; to understand the types or varieties of cotton, jute and groundnut; to understand the climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall, needed to grow cotton, jute, groundnuts, mustard, soybean, linseed and castor; to know about the soil which is best suited to grow all these crops; to understand the methods of cultivation of cotton, jute, groundnuts, mustard, soybean and non-edible oil seeds like linseed and castor; to know about the characteristics of each of the above crops; to understand the uses of the two most important cash crop, that is cotton and jute, non-edible oil seeds like linseed and castor, and main edible oil seeds like groundnut, mustard and soybean; to go through the areas where cotton, jute, groundnuts, mustard, soybean, linseed and castor are grown in India. Now, before proceeding with the new cash crop, let us recall the oil seeds, that is edible and non-edible oil seeds, through various terms and cross questions covered in the topics. Number 1, oil seeds. Number 2, edible oil seeds. Number 3, non-edible oil seeds. Number 4, leguminous crops. Number 5, rabi season. Number 6, kharif season. Number 7, oil cake. Number 8, sandy looms. Number 9, clay looms. Now let us go through the various cross questions. What are the uses of oil extracted from the oil seeds? Name any two edible and two non-edible oil seeds. What type of soils are required to grow groundnut, mustard and soybean? What type of soils are required to grow non-edible oil seeds like linseed and castor? What are the characteristics of groundnut and mustard? Differentiate between groundnut and mustard on the basis of their climatic requirements, that is their temperature and rainfall. State the climatic requirements of linseed and castor. List the two uses of each of the following crops, that is groundnut, mustard, soybean, linseed and castor. List any two main producers, that is two main states producing each of the following crops. Number 1, groundnut. Number 2, mustard. Number 3, soybean. Number 4, linseed. Number 5, castor. Now, coming to our topic of the day, that is sugarcane, it means that we will read pages 229 to 231 with the following objectives: to know about the type of sugarcane, to understand the types of soils in which sugarcane can be grown, to understand the climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow sugarcane, to understand the methods of cultivation of sugarcane under the headings set method and ratooning, to go through the advantages and disadvantages of ratooning, to know about the insects against whom sugarcane plant needs to be protected, to understand the diseases that affect the sugarcane plant, to know about the characteristics of sugarcane, to understand the uses of sugarcane, to know the distribution of sugarcane in North and South India, to understand the differences between the sugarcane of North and South India, to go through the problems of sugarcane cultivation. Sugarcane is an oldest and the most popular crop amongst the important cash crops in India. It is a major crop of tropical and subtropical region worldwide. It basically belongs to the family of grass. India is the second largest producer of sugarcane after Brazil. In countries like Cuba and Jamaica and even India, sugar is produced from the sugarcane, while in many other places, beetroots, that is chukandar, is used to make sugar. Sugarcane is also used in making other products like gur or jaggery, khansari, that is the shakkar you eat in winters, and other byproducts like molasses, press bud, and bagasse. Sugarcane grows well in the hot and humid climate and moderate rainfall. It can be grown in the variety of soils and needs manual labor as it is a very heavy crop. That is, the work of processing the sugar grain from growing to harvesting is done by hands. It is grown mainly for its sucrose content, that is, amount of sweetness present in its stem. It is mainly processed through the ratooning method. It is sown both in North as well as South India. Though Uttar Pradesh is its largest producer, but South India, mainly Tamil Nadu, gives higher yield. And the better quality of sugarcane from the vast tracts of black lava soil. But before reading the chapter from the book, let us discuss various technical terms covered in the topic. Number one, bamboo. Bamboo is a giant woody grass which is grown chiefly in the tropics. Number two, clay loam. Clay loam is a soil that contains 60% of clay and only 10% sand. Number three, set method. Set method is the method of cutting the sugarcane into several pieces known as sets, leaving the root intact in the soil. Next is ratooning. Ratooning is a method in which after the first crop, sugarcane is cut, leaving the root intact in the soil. The lower part of the stem, which is left in the soil, is well fertilized and the stem begins to grow again. Next is sets. Sets are the stalk cuttings of two or three joints. Last, ratoon. Ratoon is a stalk cutting shoot from the root stalk of sugar cane which has been cut. So children, open your book on page number 229. Now let us start reading of the topic sugar cane. Sugar cane, a kharif crop. Sugarcane is one of the most important cash crop of India. That is, it is grown on a large scale for sale in the market to earn profit. It belongs to the bamboo family, that is, a grass-like plant and indigenous to India, that is, native or belonging to a place. It is the main source of gur, khansari, that is, shakkar, and white sugar, which is used in our home. It is also used as a fodder, that is, food for the animals. It is a tropical crop, that is, grown between 23.5 degree north and south latitudes in the kharif season, that is, in the summer cropping season, that is, mainly in the months of March or April. And the seeds are sown in the month of June on the arrival of rainfall. Now let us study the soils which are required for the growth of sugarcane. Sugarcane can be grown on a variety of soils, but alluvial clay loams, that which consist of 60% of clay and 10% of sand of the Indo-Gangetic plains, that is the plains formed by River Indus and Ganga, are ideal, that is best suited for its growth. In south, it is grown on black soil and brown or reddish loams. Again, here loams is a mixture of sand and clay. Therefore, sugarcane can grow on any type of soil as long as the soil can retain moisture. That is, as long as the soil can hold the maximum amount of water vapor. The soil should be rich in nitrogen, calcium and phosphorus. Acidic or alkaline soils are harmful for the plant as they can destroy the plants. Sugarcane exhausts, that is, ends completely the fertility of the soil and extensively, that is, on a large scale. Therefore, its cultivation requires a heavy dose of manure, that is animal dung, and fertilizers, that is the chemicals which are used to increase the fertility of soil in order to obtain high yield, that is output of the crops. Flat level lands, that is plains or plateau region, are ideal for the sugarcane cultivation as these facilitate irrigation and transportation of the cane to the industries. Here, irrigation in the plains means that the means of irrigation, that is canals, wells, tube wells, are well developed to supply water to the top sugarcane. So let us study the climatic requirements of sugarcane. Temperature. Sugarcane needs an average temperature ranging from 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Excessive temperature or very low temperature, that is neither too high temperature or very low temperature, and dry winds are harmful for the plant. Short, cool, dry winter season during ripening and harvesting is ideal. Frost is injurious, that is harmful to the plant. Hence, harvesting should be done before the winter season, especially in the north. Now let us see its rainfall requirement. Sugarcane needs a rainfall of about 75 cm to 120 cm. It means that it needs a moderate rainfall. It can stand water logging, that is depositing of water at a particular place. It is a long duration crop and takes about 15 to 18 months, that is round about 1.5 years to mature, depending on the geographic conditions. Now let us go through its method of cultivation. Sowing. The ground is prepared in advance by plowing and harrowing, that is breaking up of the soil, adequate, that is sufficient application of natural manure, that is cow dung, is essential before planting. Sugarcane can be cultivated by Seth's method, but now this method has become obsolete, that is old. Now let us study the first important method of it, that is set method. Through this you will learn an important term also, that is set method, used in the cultivation of sugarcane. At present, a new set method is used. Sugarcane is a long bamboo-like stem with several joints. For preparing the sets, the sugarcane is cut into several pieces at the joint. These are known as sets. So children, from here you have learned what are sets also. Now these sets are prepared from healthy and well matured canes. They are planted in well prepared matured furrows at regular intervals. Weeds, that is unwanted plants, are cleared periodically and soil is gathered around the plants. The plant starts growing in about 2 weeks, that is about 14 days. The plant needs enough moisture in the soil. Therefore, rainfall should be well distributed or irrigation facility should be made available. That is in the areas where the rainfall is less, there the water is provided for irrigation to the crops with the help of artificial means such as canals, wells and tube wells. Now, another important term which is covered here is ratooning. Sugarcane Research Institute set up at Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu introduced a new method called as rotuling. So children, where is the Sugarcane Research Institution set up in India? That is at Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu. In the rotuling method, after the first crop, the sugarcane is cut, leaving the root intact, that is firm, at a place in the soil. The lower part of the stem, which is left in the soil, is well fertilized, that is, it is provided with the fertilizers, and the stem begins to grow again. This method is called rotuning. Rotun crop is the second or any other succession, that is, to be the next crop obtained from the root and left over in the field after the first crop. So children, here you have to define rotun crop. Now let us go through the advantages or benefits of rotuning. Number one, crop need not to be planted again. That is, the farmers need not to grow the seeds of the sugarcane again and again. Rotuns have relatively shorter maturation period. That is, they grow within a short time. The method of rotuning does not involve any extra expenditure, that is money spent. Hence, it is cheaper as compared to replanting the crop, that is growing the seeds of the crop again and again. Now, let us go through the disadvantages of rotuning. Productivity decreases, that is to become less in quantity with each successive crop. Hence, only one or two rotun crops are normally harvested. The crop may be affected by various pests and diseases, which we will learn in the next part of our video. Continuing with the sugarcane, let us read the diseases. The sugarcane plant has to be protected against insects such as moth, termites, whiteflies, and blackbugs. The sugarcane is also vulnerable, that is, easily attacked or harmed to fungal diseases like red rot, smut, rust, and rotun stunting. Now it's processing. Soon after harvest, sugarcane should be sent to the factory within 48 hours. Or the sucrose content, that is the amount of sweetness present in the sugarcane, falls. That is why most sugarcane factories are located near the sugarcane fields so as to save on transportation. So here, children, a very important question can be asked to you, that why are sugar factories located near the sugarcane fields? Harvesting. The sugarcane is ready for harvesting, that is, ready for cutting, when the new leaves stop coming and leaves at the lower stem begin to go yellow. In the north, harvesting is done before winter to protect it from frost. The sugarcane is cut at the ground level, leaving just the root, because sugar content is concentrated at the lower stem. The sugarcane should be harvested before the flowers appear. Now, let us read the characteristics of sugarcane. Sugarcane juice is extracted by crushing the cane. As you have seen that the sugarcane man, through the machine, extracts the juice of the sugarcane. Bullocks or electronic equipments is used for extracting the juice. As soon as the juice is extracted, it is boiled without any delay, else its sucrose content will decrease. Lime is added to remove the impurities. Like children, in your homes, if you have seen your mother boiling the sugar in the water, after boiling it, when she makes chashni of it, she adds a lemon to remove the impurities, and you can see that all the impurities float up on the upper surface of that juice. Now let us study the uses of sugarcane. About 50% of the cane is used to make gud or jaggery by boiling, and 30% of the produce is used for making white sugar. That is, mainly most of the part of the sugarcane is used to make gud or jaggery, and rest is used for making white sugar. Part of it is used to make khansari, that is shakkar, which you eat in winters, which is normally used in the North India. Sugarcane juice is popular as a drink during summer as it is very nutritious and healthy as compared to synthetic drinks, that is artificial drinks like your cold drinks. Now, let us go through the area states where sugarcane is produced in India. India has the largest area under sugarcane cultivation in the world and is the second largest producer of sugarcane in the world next to Brazil. On the basis of study of conditions of growth, three distinct belts of sugarcane cultivation are as follows. In the north, the Satluj Ganga plain, that is the plain formed by the river Satluj and Ganga from Punjab to Bihar, accounts for 50% of the total production. In the south, the black soil belt from Maharashtra to Tamil Nadu along the eastern slope of the Western Ghats, coastal Andhra Pradesh and Krishna Valley. Uttar Pradesh is the largest sugarcane producing state. In Uttar Pradesh, cultivation is carried on smaller units and irrigation from canal and tube well is more prevalent, that is commonly used. Bihar, Punjab and Haryana are the other states in the north which are the producers of sugarcane. In peninsular India, that is in South India, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh, Telangana are the major sugarcane growing areas. Now let us see the sugarcane producing areas in India through map. Children, Uttar Pradesh is the largest producer of sugarcane in India with a production of about 138,481,000 tons of sugarcane. Next comes Maharashtra, where it is grown in the vast tracts of black lava soil, accounts for an about 81,870,000 tons of sugarcane. Next comes Karnataka with an average production of 41,895,000 tons of sugarcane. After that comes your Tamil Nadu with an average production of 24,463 tons of sugarcane. Next comes your Gujarat with an annual production of 14,060,000 tons. Then Andhra Pradesh and Telangana together accounts for 13,150,000 tons of sugarcane. After that, we have Punjab with a production of 7,039 hectares, Uttar Pradesh with a production of 7,650,000 hectares of sugarcane, and Bihar with a production of 14,131,000 tons of sugarcane. Now, sugarcane cultivation in North India. In northern plains of India, the temperature ranges from 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. The fertile soil of the Indo-Gangetic plains with a relatively high rainfall of 120 to 150 centimeter provides ideal, that is suitable, conditions for growing sugarcane. In the dry areas, it is grown with irrigation. Uttar Pradesh has an excellent network of canals and tube wells, which makes it the largest producer of sugarcane in India. The dry winds or loo, that is hot, dry and dusty winds, blows in May and June, affect the normal growth of sugarcane. Now, let us read the sugarcane cultivation in peninsular India, that is in South India. Though the area under sugarcane cultivation is less in peninsular India, the yield per hectare, that is the output of the sugarcane, is much higher. The average yield in north is 40 tons per hectare, whereas in south it is 80 tons per hectare. The reasons are, in the south the climatic conditions are ideal, that is suitable, with the absence of loo during summers with reasonably high temperature, frost-free winters coupled with, that is mixed with, maritime, that is equable winds in coastal areas. That is the areas near to the sea coast. The black lava soils with their high fertility and retentivity to, that is the capacity to hold the moisture, are most beneficial for the sugarcane crop. Better methods, manures, that is animal dung, fertilizers, that is chemicals used to increase the fertility of soils, are used for cultivation in the south. Problems of sugarcane cultivation. Sugarcane is a soil exhausting crop, that is, it brings the fertility of the soil to an end. It needs plenty of manure and water for the plants so that the lost fertility can be regained. Mills are away from the fields, that is the sugar mills are located away, hence problem of transport occurs. High cost of production. As the sugarcane is a heavy crop, that is why its cost of production is quite high. Prices are fixed on quantity and not on quality. So children, I hope that through this video you have learned what type of crop is sugarcane, type of soil in which sugarcane is grown, climatic requirements, that is temperature and rainfall needed to grow sugarcane, its method of cultivation, that is set method and ratooning, which are very important, advantages and disadvantages of ratooning, diseases that harm the crop, uses of sugarcane, area states where sugarcane is grown in India, sugarcane cultivation in North India and South India, problems of sugarcane cultivation. Thank you.